In this video, you'll see how to configure Amazon Managed Grafana with Grafana Teams. With this solution, you can simplify user access management, manage permissions for multiple users with similar access requirements, and synchronize team membership between your Grafana workspace and your identity provider. To get started, let's create an Amazon Managed Grafana workspace. We'll enter a workspace name and description. For our purposes, we'll use Security Assertion Markup Language, or SAML, as our authentication method. Let's proceed with Service Managed Permission. Let's grant access to all data sources. We'll specify Amazon Simple Notification Service, or SNS, as the notification channel. Now we'll review the settings and create the workspace. The summary shows that the workspace is now active, but SAML needs to be configured. To complete the SAML configuration, we need the metadata from our identity provider. In this case, our SAML identity provider is Okta. Let's paste in the metadata URL. Next, we'll configure SAML assertion attributes to map our identity provider user information to Amazon Managed Grafana workspace users, as well as to assign orgs and users access to the workspace. Let's designate the assertion attribute role as name and provide an admin role value called admin. For the purposes of this example, we'll add some optional assertion attribute settings that will be used to map to Grafana Teams. We'll also specify an editor role value. Let's save this configuration. The SAML setup is now complete, and the Amazon Managed Grafana workspace URL is ready for us to log in. We'll sign in with our Okta SAML user ID. Now that we've logged into Amazon Managed Grafana, let's configure our team settings. Grafana Teams enable us to grant permissions to a group of users. Let's create a new team. We can add individual members to this team or use the external group sync feature to set up synchronization between our authorization providers groups and our team in Grafana. We'll specify an external group ID that matches one of our Okta attributes. Whenever a user with that attribute in their Okta profile logs in, they will automatically be assigned to the team. Next, let's log out and try to log in as a different user who has that external group ID assigned as an attribute in their Okta profile. We'll log in as an editor user. Notice that this user does not have the configuration or admin consoles. However, the external group sync feature has added this user to the team we created. Let's confirm this by signing out and logging back in as an admin. Let's take a look at our team's configuration. We have one member now. As you can see, the editor user we logged in as earlier is now part of this team. To further validate this, let's set up a data source that we can query. For the purposes of this example, we'll use Amazon CloudWatch. We'll select our default region and add the data source. Let's go to Settings to take a look. Let's save and test this data source. Next, let's enable permissions for this data source. Based on the workspace configuration, only admin IDs or admin roles can access this data source. Let's grant permission to query to everyone on the team we added. Next, let's set up a dashboard. In this case, we'll import an Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud or Amazon EC2 dashboard. Let's browse our dashboards to find it and load it. Let's take a look at the permissions for this dashboard. As you can see, the editor role has edit permission and the viewer role has view permission. Let's remove these permissions and grant permissions only to the team we created. We'll grant view permission. Let's save the dashboard, sign out, and then sign in as the editor user. Now let's look for the Amazon EC2 dashboard. As expected, this user is able to view the dashboard. The user can also create a new dashboard using CloudWatch as a data source. You've just seen how to configure Amazon-managed Grafana with Grafana Teams. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.